Well, Kanye. It is the beginning of the journey through Kanye West. Gonna start with College Dropout. There's so much I want to say about Kanye, but I don't know anything about the guy other than just the random bullshit that has happened, kind of in the public eye. To my knowledge, the only song I've heard from him is when he was singing with Tyler, the Creator on Smuckers, I believe, which was off of Cherry Bomb, I believe. It's a tough thing when someone who is a great artist also becomes a little odd out in the public eye. I like to try and maintain a firm boundary between music and people because some of the greatest musicians are just the oddest fucking people on the planet. Kanye West to me seems a little strange. I don't want to judge the guy. I obviously don't know the guy. There's no reason to judge the guy. I don't get anything from it. But I will say a couple of things of what I know about Kanye West. I still vividly remember Hurricane Katrina and him and Mike Myers doing some like fundraising thing or something. And on live TV, he just straight up says George Bush does not care about black people. And Mike Myers, who is a comedian, who has a comedic mind, is speechless. I mean, speechless. He doesn't, he like, it's like someone just slapped him in the mouth and then the camera cuts away. Oh my God. Oh my God. And then, of course, there's Kanye West, the gay fish, because he likes fish sticks and he likes to put them in his mouth. And if you don't know who that's about, you got to watch some South Park to understand that one. Kim Kardashian, I don't give a flying fuck about Kim Kardashian. Sorry. I don't know why anybody does. As far as him running for president, it seemed strange because he kept see he the way he was presenting it, he was it seemed as if he was sincere, but he did it so late and it was all just, I don't know. And what he said, oh, God spoke to me and told me to be president. Yeah, sure, okay. Whatever. Anyway, there you go. So that's what I know about Kanye. What I've heard from Kanye, to my knowledge, is only Smuckers. College Dropout, from what I understand, is one of his earliest albums. Everyone told me to start here. So here we go. I've got the lyrics up. I saw that it's 1 hour and 16 minutes long. It's going to be a long ass ride. Of course, the video is going to get blocked by YouTube. But whatever, here we go. College Dropout, Kanye West.
Kanye, can I talk to you for a minute? Me and the other faculty members was wondering, could you do a little song, something beautiful, something that the kids are gonna love when they hit? It's gonna make them start jumping up and down and sharing candy and stuff. You could probably do something for the kids for graduation to sing.
So it says here that somebody's impersonating Bernie Mac, and that was a pretty good impersonation. Well done. Well done.
Oh, yeah. I got the perfect song for the kids to sing.
And all my people that's drug dealing just to get by. Stack your money till it gets sky high.
Pretty good sound.
To make it past 25. Jokes on you, we still alive. Throw your hands up in the sky and say, rap and get a job. You gotta do something, man. Your ass is grown. Drug dealing just to get by. Stack.
Well, I'm caught off guard by the sound. I didn't expect it. I guess I expected something a little bit more aggressive in sound, in tone. Although I don't really know why. I think the idea I have of Kanye is that he's just like an angry person. Opening verse is pretty good. Only adult man I knew that wasn't broke is the guy selling drugs and he's got his starter coat and all this other stuff. It sucks. It sucks that this is a reality for so many people that they live in just a shit situation where all you can do is fucking do drugs to get by. I know it's a long album. I know I'm kind of just talking for the sake of talking, it seems like, but I'm trying very hard to create a video that won't get blocked by YouTube. So you will have some extensive speaking on my part. I apologize.
Your money till it gets sky high. Kids sing, kids sing.
We weren't supposed to make it past 25. Joke's on you, we still alive. Throw your hands up in the sky and say we don't care what we
the second
say.
Verse is from my dogs working nine until the day we get cake. And we don't care what people say.
It seems sarcastic. Like, especially the chorus about drug dealing just to get by and stack your money and kids sing and we weren't supposed to make it past 25, jokes on you, we're still alive. And the way it's presented is like cheery and happy and it seems sarcastic. That's the impression I get. Like, yay, we're all so happy that we're struggling to get by and we have to deal drugs and work all these extra jobs just to fucking barely buy stuff to get makeup and I have to play the lottery if I want to buy a house and yay and I'm happy I'm over 25 and I didn't get fucking killed on the street, yay, good for me, you know, like it's like I feel like the underlying message on this song really is fuck you. Like this is all bullshit and I'm not supposed to be happy about it. So, okay, you want me to do something nice for the kids and sing a song and yay, we're so happy. Yeah, here's your fucking happy song. Especially having the kids in there. And with that saxophone in the background, it almost sounds like an after-school special. I don't know if that's the intent. I hope that is the intent. Otherwise, I'm kind of trashing the song a little bit, but let's keep going anyway.
Act the fool when you stop the programs for after school. And they DCFS, some of them dyslexic. They favorite 50 cents on 12 questions. We scream, rocks, blows, we part. See, now we smart. We ain't retards the way teachers start. Hold up, hold fast.
We just to get by.
There's cheeriness in this verse or this chorus. I really feel like it's sarcastic.
What the fuck?
It kind of reminds me the attitude. It kind of reminds me of "Smells Like Teen Spirit" from Nirvana. It just, well, at least the video. And I don't really know why it reminds me of that song. I just get that vibe of this bullshit school spirit, be happy for things that you shouldn't be happy about from that. Okay, anyway, graduation. I'm going to try and crank through here so I'm not talking too much.
Hey, I told you to do some shit for the kids. You give me your motherfucking graduating tickets right now. You give me this motherfucking rope, buddy, as you get the fuck out of this campus.
Why is it edited on Spotify? Huh, that's weird. I like this beat. Okay. So I'm feeling somewhat accurate on my assessment about how that We Don't Care is a sarcastic song. All right, well, let's keep going. Looks like there's a bit of a story unfolding here. This is track four, All Falls Down.
Yeah. All falls down.
This is the real one, baby.
Okay, here's the real one. All right.
South side. We gon' set this party off right. West side. She named her daughter Alexis. Yeah, hair so long that it looked like weave. Then she cut it all off. Now she look like Eve. And she be dealing with some issues that you can't believe. Single black female addicted to retail as well.
Cool beat. Cool rhythm. I like the backing vocals there. I guess this is Selena Johnson. When It All Falls Down, these lines that she's singing. Really kind of hearing Kanye's voice for the first time. Very clear. I like his errs there as he's kind of dragging him through on those couple lines. Again, it seems like a nod towards sarcasm, talking about the concept of school seems so secure. Sophomore 3 years, which means she isn't doing shit. She's obviously struggling. Hasn't picked a career. Fuck it, I'll stay down here and do hair. So no real job prospects because no career path because struggling through school. Let's keep going. This is cool. I like this. And when it falls down, who you gonna call now? Come on, come on. Easy to get into the beat on this one.
I'm so self-conscious. That's why you always see me with at least one of my watches. Rollies and posses that drove me crazy. I can't even pronounce nothing past that for safety. Then I spent $400 on this just to be like, nigga, you ain't up on this. And for that paper, look how low we are stoop. Even if you in a band, you still a nigga. Come on, come on.
That's a good closing line on that verse. I like this thing about the American dream and the people highest up have the lowest self-esteem. It seems to be the case. Well, I don't know. It's easy to say that. It's easy to, you know, kind of flip the ivory tower and be like the lowly peasant looking at the rich people going, oh, look how insecure you are and how you need all these things to try and make yourself feel better and all this other shit. The prettiest people do the ugliest things for the road to riches and diamond rings. You know, the first thing I think of is some of these shitty politicians that went in, got elected under these things of, I'm going to stand for the people. And then what do when they get in? They just fucking turn and take lobbyist money and do whatever they want. We shine because they hate us, floss because they degrade us. Yeah, this is cool. The up here, the summary is talking about his struggle with consumerism, but I like this verse. Talking about spending money on things when he can't even go to the grocery store. And when it falls down, who you gonna call now? Come on, come on. I like this Selena Johnson. I say fuck the police, that's how I treat them. We buy our way out of jail, but we can't buy freedom. We'll buy fucking a lot of clothes, but we don't really need them. Before I get it, we all self-conscious. I'm just the first to admit. Nice. Come on, come on. And when it falls down, who you... This is good. I like, too, how it seems, Kanye, he seems very comfortable with his verses and with how he's doing the lyrics here. It seems very comfortable. Sometimes I hear some of these rappers and some of them go for speed or some of them go for power. And sometimes it feels like it's just a little beyond their capability. You know, with Kanye, I picture just a quarterback chilling in the pocket and all the shit's going on around him. He's like, no, I'm fine. I know exactly what I'm doing. I've got everything timed down perfectly. Buy our way out of jail, but we can't buy freedom. Fucking A. Absolutely true. Buy a lot of clothes and we really don't need them. Yep. White man gets paid off of all of that. There's a Queens of the Stone Age song. I can't remember how it goes. It's so hard to remember another song when you listen to one. What is it? Buy flash cars, diamond rings, expensive holes to fill with things or something like that. Anyway, let's keep going. Let's keep going. Come on, come on. And when it all falls down, great supporting vocals here. Celine Johnson, fantastic vocals. That's All Falls Down. I enjoyed that track. I didn't love that track. And I'm kind of realizing now, it feels very clean. Very clean. I like when songs get raw, when they get loud. I like distortion. You know, that's just kind of my metal rocker side for preference. So, good song, good lyrics, good beat, but it all feels pretty clean. So I'm hoping if we're in track four, I'm hoping that the story kind of continues and maybe
working like this
unravels a bit.
It's like a slave ship. One bad morning when this life is
track is a rendition of I'll Fly Away, a gospel hymn that was written by Albert Brumley in 1929. There's a song or a game I like called Fallout 4, the Fallout series. And they have kind of old-timey music set in this radioactive waste post-apocalyptic world. And I love it. And this reminds me of those style of songs, which it should since it's from the original's from 1929. So it feels like that track is kind of a nod to this life sucks, you know, this struggling to get by, this consumerism where we're buying shit that we don't need. I would love to get out of this life. So that's what I get from that track right there. I'll Fly Away. All right, track six is
Spaceship. I've been working as grave shift, and I ain't shit. I wish I could buy me a spaceship and fly.
I swear I did.
I like the little, the little tap in there.
I've been working as grave shift, and I ain't made shit. I went
caught. They take me to the back and pat me, asking me about some khakis. But let some black people walk in, I bet you they show off they token blackie. Oh, now they love Kanye, let's put them all in the front of the store. Some on break, next to the no smoking sign with a blunt in the mall. Taking my hits, deserves that Maybach. So many records in my basement, I'm just waiting on my spaceship. I've been black, working this
crazy. Huh. Pretty straightforward, you know, shitty job, doesn't want to work there. Obviously, most people don't. Shitty jobs are shitty jobs. I know it's redundant. But unfortunately, this is a theme that's all too common throughout music and art and you know, just everything. It's nice that it served, seems to have served as a bit of a motivation just to fucking get out of it. Every now and then, you know, I'm torn with these general messages of, you know, I was working hard to get out of it. Because it's a good message. And I like that people do that. I like that people get out of a situation to improve their lives. But at the same time, I don't like the idea that... The side effect of this seems to be that you can't rest. And I don't like that idea either, because everyone needs downtime. Everyone needs to recharge. Everyone needs to enjoy life. Because if you can't enjoy life, I don't know what you're doing. And sometimes you're in a position where you're not allowed to just because of your conditions. And so obviously that sucks. But I don't want people to buy into this idea that they always have to keep chasing something, even if their life is pretty decent. Because at some point, you're going to get to the end of the road and realize you missed your whole life because all you did was chase the thing that you never had instead of enjoying what you do have. So it's important to enjoy what you do have if the option exists. There's my soapbox sermon for this morning. You know, I'll be passing around the donation plate later, of course.
And I ain't made shit. I wish I could buy me a spaceship and fly.
I like the drum beat on this one, especially when it goes to the right there, when that double bass kicks in.
Man,
it's cool.
Way back in the sky to 12 when my schedule headset 9. Putting no ass on shelves, waiting patiently. I ask myself where I want to go, where I want to be. Life is much more than running in the streets. Holler, hey, yay, hit me with the beat. Put me on my feet, sound so sweet. Yes, I'm the same OG, same goat. It's my beast.
Pretty good jam. Pretty good jam. I'm liking this one. You know, I hate to say the same thing over and over again, but it bums me out that there's just so many fucking people that have to put up with garbage just to try and get by, you know? God, especially now. I mean, this came out in what, 2004, it says. And ever since the pandemic and all the shit that's happened, then billionaires just made fucking way more money, and everybody who needs the money has a lot less, and just this wealth inequality just keeps going crazy. I fucking hate it. I really hate it. Yeah. Anyway, cool. I really like the drum beats on this one. Diddle 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 boom boom. It's a good beat. I kind of like the ooh in the background. Yeah, this is pretty cool jam. It's kind of chill though, given the lyrical content. Again, like I said on the All Falls Down, it still feels pretty clean. You know, if this were a rock song or a metal song, they'd be screaming about how they hate their job, and they'd be thrashing the drums and going crazy and shit. So it still surprisingly kind of chill. But maybe that's a good thing. Maybe the idea is that, no, this isn't anything to get upset about. Yes, this is not a great situation, but I'm going to get over this, and so it's not really worth my time to be upset. So we're just going to work through this problem. Like every problem, there is a solution, and I know what the solution is, and we're just going to move forward, and we're not going to burn a lot of emotional calories on it. Yeah. We'll stick with that for now. I wish I could buy me a spaceship and fly. I wish I could buy me a spaceship and fly. I'm finally noticing there is a bass line in that too. It's way tucked away in the back. I've been working this great shift and I ain't made shit. I wish I could buy me a spaceship and fly. So that was track 6, Spaceship. That's a cool song. I'm reminded that Kanye is a religious person. I think he's gotten like really religious recently. I assume his upbringing was religious. Some of this stuff does remind me of kind of a church choir-ish sound. Just with the supporting vocals and you know, talking about a chariot picking him up and heaven knows and... And because it's not angry, like I've heard these tracks. I'm ready for some angry Kanye. I hope there's some angry coming. The next track is called Jesus Walks. So let's roll into this one without looking at the lyrics first. Let's let the music play.
We at war. We at war with terrorism, racism. Most of all, we at war with ourselves. God, show me the way because the devil's trying to break me down.
So I know I'm always pausing right before different drops. I do that because I want to listen to a full verse and a full chorus. So I know somebody left a comment the other day like, God damn it, you keep pausing it at the worst possible times. I know. I apologize. This will be a challenging song for me because I'm not really religious. And so I'm curious to see how that goes with him and how it, you know, kind of tinkers with my brain.
You know what the Midwest is, young and restless, restless. Nigga. Might snatch your necklace, the next D might jack your Lexus. Somebody tell you who Kanye West is. I walk through the valley of the shadow where death is. Top floor, the view alone will leave you breathless. And I don't think there's nothing I can do now to right my wrongs. I wanna talk to God, but I'm afraid because we ain't spoken so long.
Interesting, up here it says that this was a breakthrough song, bombshell with the music community because it was a pop song endorsing Christianity, which really never crossed my mind, but I suppose that's lyrical content that isn't very common in hip-hop. This is kind of an interesting song. You know, again, it's always this struggle of trying to survive and doing what you have to do and getting a little lawless, if you want to say, you know, stealing cars and necklaces and stuff like that. What is the Valley of Cheat? Oh, I guess I can click it. Somebody told me that you can click these lines and they tell you more, which is very cool. Oh, Gangster's Paradise, sure. What is Chi? Oh, well, whatever. I don't want to spend too much time on that. This is going to be a long ass video anyway. All right, let's get to the next verse. Cool beat, a little bit of a darker tone, which makes sense when he's referencing the Valley of Death, walking through the Valley of Death, and you know, kind of hoping Jesus is with them, but worried that he might not be.
To the hustlers, killers, murderers, drug killers, even the scribblers. Jesus was with them. To the victims of welfare, feel we living in hell here. Hell yeah. Jesus was then I hope it take away from my sins and bring the day that I'm dreaming about. Next time I'm in the club, everybody screaming out.
That's
God
cool.
Show me the way because the devil's trying to break me down. The only thing that
I pray is that my feet don't fail me now.
That's a cool, I like that closing verse here. I gotta commend Kanye for doing something that is probably in his industry, in his genre, something that's obviously not what's supposed to be done. And I like it when a musician will break down boundaries. I really enjoyed Tyler, the Creator's Cherry Bomb album because it sounded like a fucking industrial metal album. This is cool. This is a good stab at hip-hop in general, really. Like, yeah, why can't I rap about Jesus? You know? What's wrong with that? Why is that wrong? Yeah, it's cool. Darker tone. I like too, the second verse. He's getting a little angry, a little frustrated. So if this album has any kind of story associated with it, I always love a good downward spiral. I'm hoping we're kind of getting into the first downward turn here, or at least getting into some frustration here. All right, next track, Never Let Me Down.
That's right. It's what I do. Come on.
One thing I found. Uh-huh. One thing I found. Oh, no, you never let me down.
I ain't never let you down. Get up, I get it.
Oh, okay, Jay-Z.
Get up, I get
it. I am aware of Jay-Z.
Yo, first I snatched the streets, then I snatched the charts. First I had they ear, now I have they heart. Money's charged, y'all niggas visiting. This whole condition, Jeff Gordon the rap. I'm back to claim pole position. Holla at your boy.
Get up, I get. Get up, I get. Get up, I get. Get up, I get. Damn.
So I do know some of Jay-Z's. One of my guilty pleasures is Big Pimpin', and the reason why I was in the military, and when I got out of boot camp, you know, you're in boot camp. Boot camp was actually pretty easy. I was Navy, and it was the hardest part was not getting any sleep. But you can't fucking listen to music, and that was hard. That was hard. Like 10 weeks of not being able to listen to any music. Like holy shit. And so. Get out of boot camp, graduate. That night, we're flying out of Chicago. And so we're in a bus. You know, they're taking us to the airport. And it's, you know, not a bus, like a big white van. And this guy's driving the bus. And he puts on Big Pimpin'. And he just fucking blasts it, right? And we're hauling out down the freeway. And he's putting his hands up and shit while he's driving and fucking. And I remember sitting there thinking to myself, I'm so happy right now. I'm so happy. I can finally just absorb some music. And I'd never heard the song before. And I wasn't a rap fan back then. But I was like, I love this song. Because it was just one of the first things I heard getting out. Pretty good lines here by Jay-Z. It's kind of interesting to hear. Well, I think I wanted to criticize him for talking about, you know, life is hard. This is hard living mixed with crystal sipping, because I don't know what that is, but it's probably fancy. But how are you going to reference that when before you're kind of, well, not Jay-Z, but earlier tracks were saying how, you know, kind of consumerism is bad. Anyway, you got to have fun. I don't want to focus on that too much. I shouldn't. I'm not being fair there. But I do like this. Seen rovers roll up with ribbons, repoed, resold, and redriven. I like that. That's a good line. Okay, let's get into Kanye's verse here.
My grandfather who took my mama made her sit in that seat where white folks ain't want us to eat. At the tender age of 6, she was arrested for the sit-ins. And with that in my blood, I was born to be different. That's what an accident did to left eye. First Aaliyah, now Romeo must die. I know I got angels watching me from the other side.
Yeah. That's good verse. Good verse. I mean, this is just straight truth. Right there. And this is kind of one of the reasons why I'm here doing hip hop and especially going through albums now. I want to understand more of this side of the world. You know, this is a life I don't know. And it comes up pretty commonly so far. Tyler, Kendrick Lamar, Kanye. I mean, this is just reality. And so I'm trying to understand more of this reality. I really like the line, Whereas racism is still alive, they're just concealing it. Yep. Yes. Yes. Yes, they are. Okay, let's keep going. This is tough. I have to try and talk some so that my videos don't get blocked, but I know you guys want to enjoy the music as well. I still... I like this too. I'm still wanting anger. Like, Kanye's saying these things and they're absolutely true, but like, where's the fucking rage, man? Like, where's the just raw, you know? I don't know, maybe he's better at handling this. Maybe he's kind of taking on the role of more of trying to be somebody who's preaching, who's guiding, who's trying to turn the tide a little bit. You know, more of a shepherd rather than a howling wolf like what I want. But you want to hear this, it makes me mad. And when I get mad, I want to scream and I want to rage and I want the music to get loud and I want it to just go nuts. Anyway, but maybe, I don't know, maybe I'm onto something with him trying to be more of a leader and just kind of wake people up a little bit with this idea that he has of let's focus on non-materialistic shit to better ourselves.
We're all here for a reason on a particular path. You don't need a curriculum to know that you are part of the math. Cats think I'm delirious, but I'm so damn serious. That's why I expose my soul to the globe, the world. Clenched onto your life in my grip. I would never, ever let you down. And when these words are found,
really
let it be known that God's membership has been signed with a language called love. That's why my breath is felt by the deaf. And why my words are heard and confined to the ears of the blind. I too dream in color and in rhyme. So I guess I'm one of a kind in a full house. Cause whenever I open my heart, my soul, or my mouth, a touch of God reigns out.
Take him to church.
That was really good. That was really good. Really good. There's one painful irony here in that think of how many conservative white people there are that are think hip hop is horrible and terrible and Kanye West, oh, and whatever. But show them this verse and they go, oh, wow, that's amazing. Oh, wow. Yeah, it was really good. Yeah. Take the time to fucking listen. This is a really good verse. Really good verse. I don't know who Jay Ivey is, but really good verse. I don't want to go down line by line because it'll take me 10 minutes because every line is very, very good. Exceptional, in my opinion. That was great. That was great. And I'm not a religious person, but that was great. Fantastic. Take him to church. I like that. I've heard this saying before. I don't know if it comes from this album or if it's something a little bit more of a broad saying that exists throughout, like hip hop. Or maybe just the black community in general. But I like taking him to church. Yeah, you did, sir. You just took us all to church. That was fucking killer. I almost feel badly for swearing because it does not seem appropriate at this moment in time. No swearing yet, has there been in this album?
Get up, I get up, I
like
get
this part too.
Get up, I get up, I get up, I get up, I get down.
No fit in them lyrics, niggas get very religious. Six Hail Marys, please, Father, forgive us. Young, the Archbishop, the Pope John Paul, and y'all niggas, the way y'all all follow Jigga. Hove's a living legend, and I tell you why. Everybody wanna be Hove, and Hove's still alive.
That's a cool jam. That's a good jam. Again, throughout, the only thing I want to complain about is it's still pretty clean. And I'm starting to think, well, this is probably just Kanye. This is how Kanye is. I'm beginning to assume that Kanye does not swear, which would make sense if he's a religious person. So, okay, I'm going to kind of fold that into my brain of expectations and try not to criticize too much on what I have been talking about. That was a cool song. That was a good song. It's tough. You know, musical preference is a thing. I just want to thrash. So I'm waiting for something heavy to come through. I don't know if it's going to come. We'll see. And if it doesn't, that's okay. catch not a problem. The beat. It's just what it is.
I'm trying to catch the beat. I'm trying to catch the beat. I'm trying to catch the beat. Nah, throw your motherfucking hand.
Well, that's
high. All the girls pass the weed to your motherfucking man.
Get them high.
Hydraulics, I can't call it, I got the swirl like alcohol. Late my freshman year, I was going through hella problems till I bit up the nerve to drop my ass up out of college. My teacher said I was a loser, I told her, why don't you kill me? I give a fuck if you feel me, I'm gonna follow my...
I understand that reference. If I'm a loser, baby, so why don't you kill me? That's a song, that was a song from the 90s.
And if you follow the charts or the plaques or the stacks, you ain't gotta guess who's back. You see, I'm so shattered that you thought I was bashing no more. Dope your motherfucking hand.
It's cool. I really liked these opening lines. The swerves like alcoholics and bounce like hydraulics. Those are good lines. Teacher says a loser. This is cool. Okay, I'm liking this one. I'm liking this one.
All the girls pass the weed to your motherfucking man.
Beat.
I ain't never tell you to put down your hands.
Seems like, generally speaking, the beats have kind of existed in a similar range. Nothing too wide in variety.
Now who the hell is this? Emailing me at 11:26.
If she think it's fly, she ain't met a real nigga yet. No. I apologize if I come off a little inconsiderate. I got the bubble cushion, the sister could get ahead of it.
Get high like noon.
This is a cool track. I like it just kind of keeps going. It's not too fast, but they don't really pause and take a breath either. They just kind of keep going with it. And the beat is really starting to grow on me a little bit. There's kind of like a quiet keyboard. I don't really know if it's a keyboard, but like the do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. And then the bump bump in the back is pretty cool.
Moon or room filled with smoke, a hype filled with dope. Y'all assumed I was doing it. But I still feel the notes.
I love it when there's these little beat hesitations. I was introduced to that doing all of my stuff with Tyler the Creator, and I really, really enjoy when they just do a little hesitation. It's cool.
Real nigga quotes. Real rappers is hard to find, like a remote. Control rap is out of. You super still got love. That's why I abuse you who are not thugs. Hooped up telling you you sick when you a dick with a loose nut. Video hard to watch like Medusa. Even your club record need a booster. Chimped up with a pimp cup, illiterate nigga. Read the infrared across your head. I'm Greg King like Simba. Bolder than Denver. I ain't a mad rapper, just an MC with a temper.
Lead to your motherfucking man.
Get him high.
I ain't never tell you to put down your hands.
Keep them high, keep them high, keep them high.
And if you're losing your high, then smoke again.
Keep them high.
Hey, what's up, girl?
The summary was it's a crowd pleaser. Yeah, I can see that. Yeah, that's just a cool little jam to hang out to. I can hear that playing in the club or something like that. This is probably just like a little skit.
Well, you looking all good and stuff.
Bro, I know. It's that workout.
Got you a six-pack. You're cool and stuff. You know what I'm saying?
My nigga, I'm tired of putting 187 in my nigga tater. Throw away my bus pass and shit. Oh, my God. Oh, shit.
You just popped in a Kanye West Get Right for the Summer workout tape. And ladies, if you follow these instructions exactly, you might be able to pull you a rapper, an NBA player. Man, at least a dude with a car. So first of all, we gon' work on the stomach. Nobody wants a little tight ass.
1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and get them sit-ups right in. Tuck your tummy tight and do your crunches like this. Give head, stop, breathe, get up, check your weed. Don't drop the burner, disrespect the weed. Pick up your center, disrespect your seed. Maybe we can work it out. Ooh, girl,
I kind of like there's an instrument going on back there. It almost sounds like a sloppy violin. I don't really know what you would call that, but it's making that violin-esque sound. I like it. Good beat. This is pretty silly, kind of a silly song, but straightforward. Let's keep going.
A cigarette. My name Kanye from the Jigga said, twist the said, get it wet. Oh girl, your breath is harsh. Cover your mouth up like you got SARS. Off them tracks, yeah, I bought them cars. Still kill a nigga on 16 bars.
Hey, my name is Jill. I just
want
to say thanks to Kanye's workout plan. I was able to pull an NBA player, and like now I shop every day on Rodeo Drive. I just want to say thank you, Kanye. Woo! My name is Asandra, and I just wanted to say, since listening to Kanye, stayed outside the family, I got a double wife, and I rode a plane, rode a plane, rode a plane.
I've been able to date outside the family. Oh, God. I have to talk every now and then. Otherwise, it's just straight up, I'm just listening to the songs, and then when YouTube blocks it, they go, see, you're just playing the music. Oh, okay, yeah, you caught me. You caught me. That was fucking funny. However, there's just not a whole lot to say about this song. It's pretty silly. It's pretty straightforward. I really like that kind of, I don't know what the instrument is, but that violin sound going on. And there's a pretty good little bass beat bouncing around in there too. I like. How did this song go over? Like, was this considered wildly sexist back in the day or whatever? I mean, I can't keep up anymore with what's sexist and what's not. This was August of 2004. Oh, it speaks to all the pressures put on women by men. Okay. That makes more sense. Because right now it's like, Jesus Christ, man, this is ridiculous.
Ladies and gentlemen, allow myself to introduce myself. This time around, I want y'all to clap with me like this.
That's right, put in work. Move your ass, go berserk.
Put in work.
Move your ass, go berserk.
Eat your salad, no dessert.
Hit that man you deserve.
Okay. That's very good. Oh, yeah.
This song doesn't recommend much in terms of workout, though, other than sit-ups and crunches. Talks about how women are really valued for their bodies. Yeah. The rapid nature of the song puts the listener in the frantic mind of a woman jumping through hoops, as it were, to please and attract men. Okay. Maybe. Sure. That's not...
I appreciate your time.
Not really where I would go with it, but I'm probably wrong. Kanye's workout plan. New workout plan. I'm excited for this next track. Slow jams with Jamie Foxx on it.
It's Foxx, man. I'm just saying. I was talking to the girls, you know, and we don't put enough emphasis on the ladies sometimes. You know, I was talking to this girl. She was talking about the music all fast in the club. You know, she got to drink water because she's thirsty. She done danced like 9,200 songs back to
9,200 back.
Everybody, you know, really try to find out what she feeling, like how she feel. You know what she told me?
Are you gonna
check it out. This is what she said. She said, oh, she said she wants some Marvin Gaye, some Luther Vandross, a little Anita, but definitely set this party on right.
Here we go.
She said she wants some ready for the world, some new additions.
Need them diamonds when she know they rise. She got a light-skinned friend look like.
Telling me they're diamonds when she knows they're rhinestones. I like the change in tone. I like the sound. And it's not, I need to learn the name of instruments. There's so many instruments I don't know the names of. But what's the drums where you, I know this, I just can't remember it. Where you tap it. Diddle. Anyway, let's keep going.
Michael Jackson got a dark skin friend. Look
that,
like Michael
right
Jackson. I play ready
I like
for
that.
The world. She was ready for some action. My dog said you ain't no freak. So you about to prove my man wrong. I will go
smoking Robinson.
I don't know hardly any of these artists. I've heard of Luther Vandross. I've heard of Marvin Gaye. I've probably heard a song or two from him as well. Smokey Robinson, I have heard of. Not Freddie Jackson. Ashford and Simpson. There's a lot of music out there I got to get onto. You know? There's a lot out there.
Smokey Robinson. Freddie Jackson.
This is a cool jam, just nice and chill.
Ashes and sink, Simpson, set the party.
The whispers, hit
hit the stoplight, move it to some eyes. These rims still moving, so I pop a little spinners while I'm hopping on the beat. Dipping through the streets, popping up a beat. And I got the heat, roll a 23. And I do it.
Dude. His lyrics go so well with that beat that I enjoy. This is cool. This is really cool. I like the rapid spitfire, and then he kind of pauses, and then that little hand drum. What the fuck is it called? Oh my God. Yeah. Sometimes I do these videos, and there are moments where I feel really dumb. Really dumb. This is great.
My earth in the wind, smoke a fire. Let me get your sheets wet. Listening to keep sweat. Put you in the days we make. Fulfilling up with every temptation. Slow driving, having deep set. You ready for the world, girl? Come and go with me. I touch you all over your body, baby. Don't say no to me. And let me know to be controlling me. I'm loving the way you be holding me when I'm listening to jealousy. And when I come over and bend your ass, you.
That was fucking good. That was really good. It's fast. But it's still understandable. It's one thing I have noticed with rap. Some people criticize. I have heard some people criticize rap, people who really don't listen to it. I can't understand what they're saying. Okay, sure, whatever. There's some Tyler tracks where there's a lot of distortion or whatever in Cherry Bomb. Maybe a little hard to understand. That was all very clear. That was all well enunciated and easy to hear and understand. And I kind of chuckle a little bit because typically the people who say I can't understand what they're saying are also the people that are listening to metal where the guys are screaming all the time. You can't understand what the fuck they're saying. So, yeah, anyway. I love that little rapid drum beat. It's so cool. Yeah. Cool jam. Pretty chill. What was that guy's name? Twista? He hammered that stuff. That was great. Yeah, that's cool. And there it is, just a little bit of soft guitar in there as well. All right, nice. All right, breathe in, breathe out. This is track 13 of 21.
Yeah, breathe in, breathe out. If you're iced up, pull your sleeves out. Push a big truck, pull your keys out. Girls go wild and pull your D's out. Breathe in, breathe out. Let them hoes fight, pull a weave out. When I pull a piece out
my stacks and I'm so broke, I look back like, damn, was I on crack? I mean, 12 platinum chains, was I on that? What the hell was wrong with me, dawg? Sing along with me, y'all.
I like that there's at least some buyer's remorse. It's one thing I have a hard time just comprehending. I'm not rich. I'm comfortable, but I am not rich at all. And the other day, me and some friends were on Zillow, and we were looking at houses in Malibu. And, you know, there's like $45 million monstrosities. And it's just like, who the fuck needs an 11,000 square foot house? What are you going to do with that? Like, sure, it's nice to be on the beach. I get that part. But it's, you know, it's kind of the same thing. Like, what the fuck do you need 12 platinum chains for? What, to do what? You know, I don't know. It is interesting to see what people do with their money when they have a lot of money. And I guess if you have a shit ton, it doesn't matter anymore. But that doesn't mean, like, I could go to the dollar store and afford all the things there. It doesn't mean it's useful at all. It's just junk. It's all junk. Even platinum chains, it's just junk. Okay, me preaching again just a little bit there. Let's get back on the track.
If you're iced up, pull your sleeves out.
Playing why he tricking off. Don't get no rich nigga. Give me some head. That'll really piss him off.
Yeah, breathe in, breathe out.
Oh,
if you're iced up, pull your sleeves out. Push a big truck, pull your keys out. Girls go wild and pull your D's out.
The beat's okay. Yeah. Alright, I hear it. Yeah, it's good beat, you know, whatever. I'm not not overly excited about it. There's nothing a whole lot to say with it. Pretty straightforward.
Let them hoes fight, pull a weave out.
I do like that. Let them fight, pull a weave out.
When I pull a piece out, niggas like pizza.
I blow past low class niggas with no cash and a 4-6, bitch, you can go ass. So when I go fast, po-po, just laugh right until I run out of gas, until I go crash. Whatever come first, I'm prepared for the worst.
Breathe in, breathe out. If you're iced up, pull your sleeves out.
So this song makes me question the sincerity of one of those early Spaceship. I think Spaceship. It makes me question the sincerity of some of his, whatever the track was where he was talking about, why can't I rap about Christianity? Because to me, this kind of flies in the face of that, you know, like this, and this is always the problem I have with love songs. I hear a love song and not that love songs are bad, but the ones that are like, oh, I love you so much and you're the only one for me and I need you forever and I can't exist without you and blah, blah, blah. And then two songs later, fuck that bitch. I don't need her. She's garbage. And so what it does is it devalues the sincerity of the previous song. And so I feel like this track, which is pretty straightforward, it kind of devalues the sincerity of the previous, I don't remember which one it was. Jesus Walks. Because if you're doing this, okay, that's fine. You go and do that. But then don't tell me about how you're all religious and you care about God and you're trying to change things and blah, blah, blah. I mean, there's some hypocrisy that exists there. Now, obviously, people are going to go out and do what they want to do. Obviously, people struggle with temptation and stuff like that, but it doesn't really seem to be any struggling here. It seems to be full-on enjoyment. So, not really a problem with the song itself, but I feel like the album, there's a conflicting message that exists there. And, you know, whatever, who cares, right? But that's what comes to mind when I hear a track like this after hearing a track like Jesus Walks. Girls go wild and pull your D's out. Honestly, I can kind of pass on this track. It's not very compelling. I feel like I could probably hear this 10 times from 10 different people and it'd be the same song. I do like the chorus. The chorus is pretty good. It's pretty funny. But, yeah, this one's kind of you know, for me. All right, now here we go. School that. Spirit skit 2.
And your
two.
Mother's saying, go to college, so you finish college and it's wonderful. You feel so good. And after all the partying and crazing, and don't forget about that drug habit you picked up at school, being around your peers, hey, now you'll get that $25,000 job a year, and you get to take messages for the secretary who never went to college. She's actually the boss's niece, so now you're part of the family. Know how many classes I took? Extra classes? No, I've never had sex, but you know what? My degree keeps me satisfied. When a lady walks to me and says, hey, you know what's sexy? I say, no, I don't know what it is, but I bet I can add up all the change in your purse very fast.
School spirit.
So, I'm glad that track came through right after I said what I said about Breathe In, Breathe Out, because it reminded me that Breathe In, Breathe Out, it may have been another stab at sarcasm. I don't think that it was. It didn't seem that way to me. I didn't get that impression. But this, immediately following that, you know, they're talking about all the partying and craziness in college, the album being College Dropout. Maybe I'm missing a little bit broader message here where Kanye is making a joke at college because of the craziness. Let's go back and read the summary up here on this. A song off of Kanye's, contains sample. Oh, there's not much else there. Okay, well, maybe Breathe In, Breathe Out is about the craziness of college and the partying and how useless it is. Well, maybe not the partying itself, but I love how this played out. How basically going to college is useless because all it does is put you right back where you were. Now you have a bunch of debt and you still have a shitty job, which is mostly true. They don't mention the debt part in here, but that's really true now. All right, let's keep going with School Spirit here. This is track 15 of 21.
Alpha step, omega step, kappa step, sigma step, gangsters walk, pimps gon' talk. Ooh, hecky no, that boy is raw.
AKA Step.
I'm liking this beat.
Step, SGO Step, Zeta Step, Gangsters Walk in Style. Told them I finished school and I started my own business. They say, oh, you graduated. No, I decided I was finished. Chasing y'all dreams and what you got planned. Now I spit it so hot, you got tan. Back to school and I hate it there, I hate it there. Everything I want, I gotta wait a year, I wait a year. Graduated at the top of our class. I went to Cheesecake, he was up for the month and waited there. Alpha.
Why is this edited? I'm listening on Spotify. It's an edited version. This is annoying. I do not want an edited version. I'm liking the lyrics. I'm not liking that Spotify. This is the album off of Spotify. I'm not liking that Spotify has edited this and cleaned it up. I like those lines. He graduated at the top of the class, but he was the waiter at Cheesecake Factory.
Omega Step, Kappa Step, Sigma Step, Gangsters Walk, Pimps Gon' Talk, Pimps Gon' Talk. Ooh, hecky, nah, that boy is raw. I feel a woo coming on, cuz. I feel a woo coming on, cuz. There was.
I feel some woos coming on, cuz. This is cool.
A couple woos coming on, cuz. There they was. I feel a woo coming on, cuz. I feel a woo coming on, cuz. There was a couple woos coming on, cuz a couple woos coming on, cuz there they was.
It's tough, like with this song, the idea of pausing and giving commentary and reaction and stuff is obviously critical when you're doing a video like this. But sometimes there's just not a whole lot to react to, in the sense that the song is straightforward, the beat is straightforward, it's an easy song to listen to. It's not terribly complicated, you know. He's just kind of knocking college, basically. I wonder if this whole album is basically, I mean, it is clearly an assault on what college is versus what it's supposed to be. It's a cool little jam though. I like it. I like the beat. I like the lyrics. And it's just easy to listen to. Looks like we got a couple more skits coming out. School Spirit skit 2. And Lil Jimmy skit. Yeah, I like that beat. A lot.
You keep it going, man. You keep those books rolling. You pick up all those books that you're gonna read and not remember, and yep. You roll, man. Spending mine to be smart, you know why? Cause when I die, buddy. You know what's going to keep me warm? That's right. Those degrees.
Oh, man. This is really hitting home with me because I have a pretty low opinion about the college system in America. Because to me, it's just a scam to steal everybody's money. And obviously, you can learn. And obviously, there are some careers that you need to go to college for. But I've met so many people who have degrees and they go, I don't even use it. And really, what you're doing is you're paying a bunch of money to a fucking institution that's backed by the federal government, in a way, through student loans that can't be defaulted out of. And that's because of the federal government, I believe. I'm going to get caught talking to my ass here, probably. Anyway, tuition just keeps going up and up and up and up, and people just keep going to school, and then they get out, and it's still a shit job that's waiting for them. So I don't know, if you're happy about going to college, great, go to college, I guess. I hope you're going to put your time and money into something that's useful. I really do. Anyway, I'm really jiving with this, making fun of college.
Hey, Jimmy, theme. Where it's you going? It's a fun theme.
I don't know where I'm going. My dad died, and he left me his degrees. My mom would always say, Dad, why don't you work? But he just kept learning. All the other kids' parents were working and saving up money for school. Without money, but I'll be the smartest deaf guy. Who has that?
Oh, my God. Oh, this is great. Oh, this is great. I mean, he's just feeding my own ego at this point. Like, yes, my opinion is being reinforced. Yes. Oh, thank you, Kanye. Thank you very much. All right, what's this one called? This is Two Words, track 18. We're getting close to the end, although the final track is 12 minutes long.
We in the streets,
there we go.
Get your mail. It's only two places you end up, either dead or in jail. Still nowhere to go. Still nowhere to go. Now throw your hands up, hustlers, busters, boosters, ho. Everybody fuck that. Still nowhere to go.
Most Def here. I am just the tiniest slight awareness of Most Def. I know that he exists. I know what he looks like because he was in the Talladega Nights movie. I know that he's a rapper because he's on a rap album. That's about it. I don't think I've ever heard any of his music before. I'm liking this song already because it's a little bit more aggressive. This album has lacked aggression. And that's fine. Not everybody's heavy, you know, but I like heavy, and it's a little odd that Kanye would address so many important topics in the way that he has and not get aggressive about it. So let's see what Mos Def does here.
United States, no love, no breaks, no brow, high stakes, crack smoke, black folks, Big Macs, fat folks, X one card, we won't stop, everybody move.
I like that verse, that was good. No, I like that verse. I'm liking the music a lot in this track. This track's got music that's a little bit more up my alley, a little bit more aggressive, a little bit louder. This is good. Two words, United States, no love, no breaks, fucking A, that's true. That is true. Big Macs, fat folks, presidential scandals. Yep. It just keeps happening over and over again.
Busters, busters, boosters, ho. Everybody fuck that. So nowhere to go, nowhere to go.
Crazy, so I live by two words.
Fuck you, baby.
Fuck you, baby.
Jesus, save me. You know how the game be. I can't let them change me. Cause on judgment day, you gon' blame me.
Nowhere to go.
I like that there's a lot going on musically. There's some backing vocals going on and the drums are going on. And is there even piano? Did I hear piano in there? I can't really recall. It gets tough when I'm trying to read the lyrics and hear the music at the same time. yeah, that's a cool jam. Let's keep going. I have to pause to talk a little bit. I hope I can figure out a way around that. I know this video is going to get blocked. I know for sure it's going to get blocked. But this is a pretty cool jam. I'm liking it.
Letters AR, turn your rap niggas to two words, fast runners. Like Jackie Turner, you better sleep with your burning
AC.
Blow a reef through your car, my God. Two words, no guns, break arms, break necks, break back, Steven Seagal free.
No. It's almost another violin, isn't it? I like that jam. That's a good one. Yeah, that's a good one. Two words. A little bit more aggressive. I think it's important. I mean, I know I keep kind of pounding that drum, but it's impressive. I mean, when you got some emotion, when you're upset about something, you got to express that. Really get that out there, especially in music. It comes out so well in music. So well in music. All right, let's jump into track 19 now. This is Through the Wire.
They can't stop me from rapping, can they? Can they hop? I spit it through the wire, man. There's too much stuff on my heart right now, man. I really apologize to everyone right now. It's unclear at all, man. They got my mouth
on
okay. Quiet shut.
It's throwing me off the way they're laying out the lyrics in this on this thing, because this lyric is the voice that's in the background, the kind of the higher pitched distorted voice, and then this is the person that's speaking, the over chorus here. That confused me on the opening portion. I didn't know where the hell I was on the lyrics. All right, let's keep going. So far this song, I'm not really, I mean, it's fine, but it's not really getting me. So let's see what else they do here.
Like 6 weeks. You know, we had reconstruction. I had reconstruction surgery on my jaw. I looked in the mirror. Half of my jaw was in the back of my mouth, man. I couldn't believe it.
Jesus.
And I'm still here for y'all right now, man. This is what I got to say right here, though. Yeah. So I turn tragedy to triumph. Yeah. Make music that's fire. Yeah. Spit my soul through the wire.
Huh. So There's been a couple of references now to a car crash. On October 23rd, Carney crashed his car, fractured his jaw. It must have been pretty bad. Recorded the original version with his mouth still wired shut. Okay, I was going to say he sounds very different here, and that must be why. Making him through the wires. Video is unavailable. YouTube blocks strike again, don't they? Huh. I wonder what he... I kind of want to know more about what he did as far as, you know, crashing his car. I was going to kind of talk shit about this song because it sounds a little different. I don't really like this back chorus that's happening. Through the fire, to the limit, to the wall, for a chance to be with you, I'll gladly risk it all. Through the fire, whatever may come. The voice... It reminds me of some video game that I did not enjoy. Anyway, I don't want to focus on negative too much. Now that I know that this is about a car crash that happened to him and he actually did it while his mouth was wired shut. Okay. A little bit more respect for the song. I mean, the lyrics are good. But the beat's not doing a whole lot for me.
You know what I'm saying? When the doctor told me I was going to have a plate in my chin. I said, dog, don't you realize I'll never make it on a plane now? It's bad enough I got all this jewelry on. She can't be serious, man.
That's funny. That's kind of funny. Okay, Through the Wire. I respect what the song is about, but the song itself, yeah, it just doesn't really jam for me. Let's do next here. This is Family Business. This is track 20. Let's see how this one goes.
How's your son? He made the team this year? He say he wasn't tall enough.
All the glitter
is my goal.
Yeah, we're gonna cook this up.
Gold is not reality.
I like this track. This is cool. He's talking more about family and the importance of family here. But again, to go back to what I was talking about with Breathe In, Breathe Out. It's harder to buy into the sincerity of a song like this when you have another track that is celebrating the opposite. But I have to be careful here because it's easy to just criticize and not, you know, try and understand all of the angles. Because it's also important to go out and have fun. I mean, everyone's going to go out and have fun. Life, family is important. But so is going out and having fun. So you can't just sit around with your family all the time. Just like you can't go out and party all the time. You got to have some variety, I guess. So that being said, I think I want to walk back my criticism just a little bit. A little bit. Because I can't just sit around and be like, oh, well, yeah, but, you know, in this song, he's saying life or family is what matters. But in the other song, he's just talking about things that aren't family. I mean, that's clearly dumb. So that doesn't really work. That doesn't make sense. You know, this line here, somebody say grace so I can save face and have a reason to cover my face. That's really good. You know, obviously he's sad that someone's not there. I assume it's his grandma here based off of this line. Granny's picture now that you're gone. Or your granny's picture now that you're gone. And I don't know if the same person that is in prison, or if there's multiple people, if there's somebody that is in prison and there's also somebody that's has passed. I don't know. Let's keep going. I'm liking this track.
Family business. And this is for everybody standing with us. Come on, let's take a family Grammy picture. Abby, remember when they ain't believe in me? Act like you ain't took a bath with your cousin. Fit three in the bed. If it's six of y'all, I'm talking about three by the head and three by the leg. But you ain't have to tell my girl I used to pee in the bed.
No. It is funny thinking back about being kids and all the kids just kind of getting jammed into one bed. It is kind of funny. I remember some of those days. Some of those days. Yeah, that's funny.
Let the sun come out and all the children sing. Rain, 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 go
Yeah, it's a cool jam. I mean, there's not a whole lot to say about it. Pretty straightforward. I like that Kanye, while clearly struggling with, you know, having money and fame and parties and stuff like that, is also appreciating and understanding the importance of family. Again, with that backing chorus, choir, I mean, this is, so again, this, I really feel like this is more of the religious side of Kanye kind of breaking through. It seems so with the music. The music's pretty simple. There's a lot more emphasis on the chorus, on the choir. It's cool. That's good. Tell me the thing. Yeah.
Let's get Stevie out of jail.
All right, last call. Last track off of College Dropout. I wonder how, I wonder if it's actually 12 minutes long. Oh my God, it looks like it. Not that I am turned off by a long track. I love long tracks. There's some Tool songs that are pretty long. But it's been a long run as well. What are we at here? Oh, an hour 45 on the video here. Well, let's close it out. I was going to talk. Let's close it out. Let's get in the last call. I'm sure I'll pause it a couple of times over the next almost 13 minutes.
Yo, here. Fuck you, Kanye, first and foremost, for making me do this shit, motherfucker. I had to throw everybody out the motherfucking room because they don't fuck.
I'd like to propose a toast. I said toast, motherfucker. I tell them insects in Texas. It's funny how wasn't nobody interested till the night I almost killed myself in Lexus. Now I ain't.
I like that there's a bass line going. I like that there's a beat. You know, the more instruments that are involved with the song, the more I tend to enjoy it. I like this beat. This is pretty good. Let's just keep going here.
And they ask me. I tell them.
The bass line's pretty cool.
This is the last call for alcohol for the. So get your ass up off the wall.
One of the things I like to do is if I think of a song, if a hip hop song reminds me of a rock song, I like to mention the rock song to you guys, because while I'm having my own journey listening to new music, sometimes it's fun for you guys to listen to new music. So the bass line I'm hearing, I like it. I'm just kind of picturing Flea from Red Hot Chili Peppers doing his thing. And there's a song called, from Red Hot Chili Peppers, it's called Soul to Squeeze. Cool jam. It's pretty mellow. So if you don't like rock, it's not heavy. But when you listen to Soul to Squeeze, listen to the bass line. Really listen to the bass line. It's a cool, cool bass line. And I'm thinking of that. This has reminded me of that bass line.
Now is Kanye the most overlooked? Yes, sir. Now is Kanye the most overbooked? Yes, sir. Do the fans want the feeling of a Tribe Called Quest? But all they got left is this guy called West. That'll take freeway, throw him on tracks with most death. You call him Quali or Quayle, I put him on songs with Jay-Z. I'm the Gap like Banana Republic and Old Navy. And ooh, it come out sweeter than Old Sadie. Nice as Bum B when I met him at the Source Awards. Girl he had with him ass coulda won the Horse Awards. And I was almost famous. Now everybody love Kanye, I'm almost raining. I turn around and reply, why yes, but I prefer the term African American Express. Brains, power, and muscle like Dame Puffy and Russell. Your boy back on the hustle, you know what I've been up to. Killing y'all niggas on that liberal shit. Mayonnaise, color bins, I push miracle whips, and I am.
Some good lines in that one. Oh man, all right, let's just keep going. I have to try and pause, but I don't want to pause. Fucking, it kills me, man. This shit kills me. YouTube, you're killing me. I don't want to pause the music. I love listening to the music. I obviously some time to react and talk about stuff, but sometimes when it's going, you just gotta let it go.
They ask me, I tell them. Raise your glasses to the sky. My whole style, where it started, when he rapped on This Can't Be Life. And I was like really the first beat of that kind that was on a Dynasty album. I could say that.
I'm assuming he's just going to talk about the rest of this here. Last call. I'll listen to it all. I'm pausing just because of a poor attempt to appease the YouTube gods. But 2001, I know that album. I like that album quite a bit. That's one of the few albums, rap albums, I've listened to consistently through the years. That was a good album. Good album. Okay, well, we keep going.
That was the resurgence of the soul sound. You know, I got to come in and track the beat. And at that time, I was still with my other management. I really wanted to roll with hip-hop. I just needed some fresh air, you know what I'm saying? Because I'm popping off the way it should have been. One of my homies, that was one of my artists, he got signed. But it was supposed to really go through my production company, but he ended up going straight with the company.
I feel like I'm just listening to a Kanye West podcast at this point. Does he just keep talking? I don't know if I'm going to finish this. This doesn't really feel like it's music. Well, let me walk that back a little bit. This is something where I'm just going to end up sitting here listening to it and reading it, which it's got another 6 minutes to go. And this kind of feels like a bit of a trap if I'm trying to not get my video blocked. So I'm actually going to pause it here. I'm not going to complete it. It sounds like the music is complete. It sounds like he's more just telling a story at this point. Which, that being said, with this being the closing track for College Dropout, initially, I was like, what the hell are we doing here? But this makes sense because he's talking about all the things that he was doing instead of being in college, I assume. I assume this has happened around the same time as college. If he went to college, I have to take this album kind of at face value because I don't know anything about Kanye. So, in that sense, it's kind of cool that he is talking about how he was doing all this different work and meeting different people and trying to make it rather than be in college, because that's the whole point. Well, I don't really know what to say at this point. I enjoyed the album. I did not love the album. I've said it throughout this video. My biggest, I don't want to say criticism, but what I felt was lacking was each track felt pretty clean. It felt pretty clean. Not in terms of like, oh, no swearing, but just the beats. I love distortion. I love distortion. I love it when a person's voice starts to get a little edgy and, you know, like, yeah, let's get some of that going on. Because he's singing about pretty important topics. He's struggling with some concepts that are difficult to struggle with, that people spend their whole lives struggling with. But I never got a sense of frustration. Now, maybe that's the point. I mean, he obviously put this together in a specific way for a reason. So maybe he doesn't want to give the presentation of being frustrated with these things. It's just part of life and he's dealing with it and he's going to deal with it in his own way. Maybe there's an element of faith that he uses to where it isn't a struggle, but it's a trial, you know, a test. Some people who are religious feel that way. When their life is difficult, they don't look at it as, oh man, all of this sucks and everything's going wrong. They go, no, God is challenging me and driving me and pushing me towards something and I have to get through this thing. So maybe that was really more of the intent. I never got that intent explicitly from the album, but there's a couple tracks with Jesus Walk and Family Business that kind of imply that, I suppose. As far as Kanye, he's got a pretty good voice, good rhymes. This is early work, as far as I understand, given his whole range of music so far. So I'm curious to see how he develops. I guess he has another album, Yeezus. That's a pretty big one. I don't know. And then I just, you know, it's interesting when you know of someone, and what you know of someone who's a famous person in the public eye, what you know of them is everybody else's opinion, you know? So many people say this about Kanye and that about Kanye and, oh, he's a prick and, oh, he's this and here's a video and look, he's yelling at the guy and here. It's so easy to take snippets of somebody's life and then edit it down to make them look a certain way, when the reality is they're much more than just those snippets. But I'm finding, listening to this album, that I had a perception of who Kanye was and what he would be like in music. And he, this fictional Kanye that existed in my mind, was not here in this album, which was good. That's what I was hoping for. I was hoping for Kanye to come out and impress me with his music, because that's what matters. And I'd say for the most part, he did. I'm liking that I'm becoming more picky a little bit about some of these beats. I think I'm kind of a Tyler, the Creator fan, really, is what happened. I went through all of that music, which was such a wide, wide range of music, that now here on this album, not that all the songs sound the same, I'm not saying that, but there's a consistency with the sound. There's not wild departures from sound, which is what Tyler tends to do. There you go. I mean, it's a pretty cool album. I'm keen on listening to more Kanye. I've got no problem with this. This is cool. He's got some great lines, some good zingers in there. Yeah, man. There you go. College Dropout. Cool stuff. I'll do my best to make sure it is unblocked for as long as possible, which might be a day or two. So it'll be 2 hours of video just down the drain again. Yeah, that was fun. Oh, listen to Soul to Squeeze by Red Hot Chili Peppers. And listen to the bass line. It's a great bass line. I've always enjoyed it. I'm actually going to go listen to it right now because it's fun. Okay, y'all. Take care. Hope you enjoyed the video if you got to watch it. There were 265 of you that got to watch the Section 80 album by Kendrick Lamar before YouTube said, so get in there fast. Get in there fast. All right. I'll see you guys.